welcome to the College Boulevard Activity Center in Olathe. Tonight's Ivy High School game of the week. Sunflower League football in Kansas, week three, as we've got Gardner Edgerton on the road taking on Olathe West. Hi, everybody. Kevin Weick, Mark Boerichter. Our sideline reporter will be Leon Liebel. Well, a team that got a lot of hype in the offseason was Olathe West. They're off to a 1-1 start after losing last week, so they'll look to bounce back tonight. A team that's kind of flown under the radar, Gardner Edgerton, 2-0, and they've won six of their last eight games. So who's the real deal, Mark Boerichter?
Well, I think we're going to find out tonight because Gardner Edgerton comes into this game with their two wins, Kevin, by a combined 80 points of point differential. They really haven't been challenged the first 2 weeks. Tonight might be their first test against a really good Olathe team, as you mentioned, lost last week to Lawrence. So it's going to be interesting to see tonight.
Time now for the Hy-Vee player profile. Quarterbacks in the spotlight. Let's start with the Trailblazers quarterback. That's Connor Elder.
Well, Connor Elder comes in leading this flex bone style of offense. It's not the most exciting offense in the world, but he still throws the ball well out of it because it's a sneaky piece where you run a steady diet of run plays all day long, and all of a sudden you sneak one down the field. He's dangerous at the quarterback position.
And this guy's returning. He's second-team all-conference McGavern for the Owls of Olathe West.
Well, Mason McGavern comes into this as basically their entire offense. And when I say that is 350 yards passing through the first two games, over 200 on the ground. The big thing tonight for me is he's missing his number one wide receiver in Jake Scott, who has 10 receptions on the year. The rest of the receiving core combined only has 9. So that's going to be the story tonight. But Mason McGavern makes everything run for this Olathe Owls offense.
But he's got his little brother helping him out. The McGavern brothers for the Owls going to be on the field tonight. Back with the opening kickoff. You're watching the Hy-Vee High School Game of the Week here on Spectrum Sports. The Game of the Week is brought to you by Hy-Vee. They're proud to support Kansas City High School Athletics. Here come the Owls out on the field here at CBAC. And the coin toss going on at the 50-yard line. Greg Culotta is your referee in charge tonight here at CBAC. Gardner Edgerton in white. In blue, Olathe West. Gardner Edgerton has won the opening coin toss and deferred their option to the second half. These teams haven't played much. The last meeting in 2019, won by Gardner Edgerton, 34-7. Beautiful night here in Olathe. Temperatures right around 80 degrees. Threat of some rain earlier on, but like the skies have cleared, and we are ready for some football. Jesse Owen, former Olathe North Star, played at Pittsburgh State as a running back for the Gorillas. He's in his second year, and he is, we mentioned, in the open, has won six of their last eight games dating back to last year. Remember, they got off to a bad start, 0-4, but then it went 4-2 down the stretch, and they're 2-0 this year. Ready to kick off the Trailblazers. It's going to be Owen Dye, the junior.
Trailblazers, number 92, Owen Dye.
Deep back for Olathe West will be Sean Swearingen, senior night here. And Olathe West trying to bounce back after a week two loss to Lawrence, 28-21. Good crowd here at CBAC. We're ready for some week three Kansas High School football. This ball into the end zone for a touchback. Elijah Hakeem able to take it, but inside the end zone a couple of yards, and we get our first look at Mason McGavern and the offense for Olathe West. McGavern put up big numbers both passing and rushing, Mark, so he's kind of a dual threat.
Well, he is a dual threat, and their entire offense runs through him, as we talked about in the open. With 350 yards passing here, three touchdowns through the first two games of the year. The important stat, too, Kevin, no interceptions from him so far on the year, but 200 yards on the ground. Missing his top wide receiver tonight, so the others are going to have to step up. But this offense is a dual threat. Everything runs through McGavern.
14 rushing touchdowns last year, 11 passing, so Very balanced, but he's without his top receiver, Jack Scott. Suffered a concussion last week, will not play tonight. Pass on first down. Down the field and incomplete. A little bit off target there as the receiver, Mason Barnard, got one hand on it. Incomplete.
Good job by the offensive line up front, giving McGavern time. And this ball just a little bit behind the receiver. Missed opportunity right there on first down.
So second down and 10 after the incompletion. Running play, not much doing. As their lead back is Vincent Gatchett. Instead, it was Micah McGavern back there as well. So we're seeing some different running backs. Gatchett was slated to start the game as their lead running back, but it looks like it's the McGavern brothers lining up in a pistol formation. Micah is a kind of a hybrid player, H-back, running back, tight end, helping his older brother. As here's Mason throwing, pass complete, and it is a first down for the Owls. As making the catch was Elijah Hakeem, the junior wide receiver.
They're going to roll McGavern out to the left-hand side, and you talked about his brother Micah sealing the edge for him. Nice little comeback route by Hakeem on the outside. And Olathe West here able to move the chains on third down.
Up to the 33-yard line, first and 10, as now we see Gatchett in the backfield. See a number of running backs tonight. Here's Gatchett up the seam. Vincent Gatchett going to take it to the house. Touchdown, Olathe West. And just like that, the Owls strike as they score from 67 yards out.
Kevin, do you think they were just resting Gatchett on the sideline for the first three plays of the game? That he could go 67 to the house and hit his head on the goalpost. But what a nice job up front by the Owls' offensive line opening that hole.
And Vincent is also their place kicker. So he will stay out there, catch his breath after going 67 to the house. And he'll try the extra point. Mason Barnard will be the holder. Burge the snap, and this extra point hooking left, no good. 6-0 start. Gatchett. Good blocking up front.
Watch up inside here. They're going to pull the left guard. This seals the hole. And then there's nobody there for Gatchett. Once he gets into the second level, just outruns everybody. But a nice job up front by the offensive line, just giving him enough space. And it was all Gatchett the rest of the way.
Say he's their most improved player on offense. A program kid. Guy that was really small as a ninth grader. Wasn't the fastest guy in the world, but he worked hard, stayed with it. Paid dividends. He also throws the javelin here at the school and wants to be a javelin thrower when he gets to college. Four plays, 80 yards. Gatchett, the long touchdown for the Owls. Deep back, Raven Powell Brown, number six. This one getting into the end zone, and it'll be a touchback. Gatchett doing it all early. PATs, kickoffs, and a touchdown run. As Connor Elder in the offense coming out. Connor Elder, as a junior last year, week one, tore his ACL in a ball game we had on TV against Mill Valley. He's still wearing the brace. But they say he is their most improved player as they run a different offense this year. As they're running the flex bone, Dustin Delaney is their new offensive coordinator. And this is the fullback up the middle. Kindler, the fullback. And Mark, we've seen this offense through many variations from St. Thomas Aquinas to Hutchinson, and Dustin Delaney is the guru of the flex bone.
Well, it's not the most exciting offense to watch from time to time, Kevin, if you like, you know, big plays, throwing the football down the field, but it's extremely effective, and everything runs through the fullback.
The pass to the outside. It's caught by the big tight end there, Austin Bowie, and he'll have a first down. Bowie headed to UCM to play college baseball as a third baseman, but shows good hands at the tight end position.
Well, these are the little wrinkles out of this. Just because they're going to run the football most of the time, you hit your big tight end out on a little hitch route to the outside. One thing we have to watch all game long here is, you mentioned Connor Elder can throw the football as well, Kevin. They're not just a complete running team.
And talking to coaches defending the flex bone, as this is the fullback and a quick nine. They always say you get lulled to sleep and forget about the pass, and they kill you with the pass. And a nice run on first down by junior running back Dawson Kindler.
Well, I mentioned everything runs through the fullback, and so the linebackers now for Olathe West are going to have their hands full tonight, playing discipline and watching your keys.
Give him eight, second down and short. And a tackle there by Cooper Novacek, the Will linebacker and leading tackler on the team. A senior, Father Jay, the principal of the school. Cooper, excellent in the classroom. And he's going to have to make a lot of stops tonight. They're going to need him, Johnson, and Swearingen to stop this flex bone with their 4-2-5 defense. Craig Gorrell, in his fifth year, is the defensive coordinator for West. First and 10 from midfield. First drive of the game. Not much doing. The defensive line kind of clogging things up. Looks like Sam Abels there, the defensive end.
Kevin, this is the other thing about this offense. Early on in the game, you, as the offensive coordinator, are going to look, see how is the defense playing you. Are they being disciplined on the outside for that potential option and sweep look as well?
Gardner Edgerton wins over Shawnee Mission East and Shawnee Mission South, and they blew him out in this running play. Not much doing. So now this is what the coaches tell me you want to do to the flex bone. Get them behind the chain. Don't let them get chunks against you, and make them throw when you expect them to throw, not when they're surprising you with the pass. Let's see if they run it or pass it here on third down and long. And now it'll be an encroachment penalty on Novacek.
Cooper Novacek just getting a little bit anxious on the outside. Gardner Edgerton going with the hard count. And Kevin, you mentioned
Olathe West, 5 yards.
Wanting to play behind the chains, you go from third and seven, third and eight here to third and two.
Huge difference.
And this is a down in the flex bone you're comfortable with, third and short.
Kindler, like he cut it back, gave a little second effort after he was hit initially, and looks like he has got the first down, moved the chains for Gardner Edgerton.
This is one thing to watch up front. These offensive linemen in a run-heavy stance in this offense. A lot of push up front. You only need 2 to 3 yards, and Kindler able to pick it up behind that offensive line.
Three-step drop, pass to the tight end. That's his second catch of this drive. That's Bowie again down the sidelines for another first down. Boy, what a big target. And they are feeding number 89 early.
Well, if you're going to play off coverage on him, it's an easy pitch and catch for your quarterback out there. And then being 6'3", 225, he's a big load to bring down.
17 yards and a first down. Blazers on the move. Trying to tie this ball game up. Kindler breaking a tackle, then wrestled down by Sean Swearingen, who the coaches say is maybe their best all-around defender, defending the pass and the run. Number two, the weak side offensive lineman. Second down and eight. That's that quick hitter. Instead, the quarterback keeps it. Fake the announcer out. Fake the defense out a little bit there as Elder rocking that right knee brace, showing off he's still got some bounce in his step and running the football.
a little quick option, little crack on the outside from your tight end. And this drive, Gardner Edgerton has been extremely heavy to the right-hand side, Kevin, getting a lot of push over there on that offensive line.
Quick toss sweep to the edge. And turning the corner for the first down is Dylan Butosh, the wingback. They have two wingbacks they align with on the flex bone, and they quick pitch it out to him, the junior. Doing a good job running the football, returning starter, and it's first and goal as Blazers in the red zone from the 8-yard line. See those wings, they line up right on the edge of the offensive lineman. This is their other wing back guy. That is Kyle Oatman, the senior, getting about 10 yards per carry. These are the big play guys, these wing backs.
Well, these are all the little wrinkles off of it, Kevin. Everything runs to the fullback, the fake to the fullback to start this offense. The wing back on a toss sweep, wing back on a handoff. Or you can hit him with the option.
Second and goal from the 4, and here's Kindler powering his way. He's in for the touchdown. Austin Kindler, junior fullback. It's a 6-6 score, 6:40 to go in the first quarter.
Well, impressive first drive by Gardner Edgerton.
Ashton Adrian try the extra point, and he delivers. 7-6 ball game, Gardner Edgerton. There's Kindler on the sideline. His 10th rushing touchdown of the year.
I mentioned impressive opening drive, and it really all up front. You see a good 3-4 yards of push by the offensive line. Really makes it an easy touchdown for Kimmel.
So a good answer by the Trailblazers as they take it 80 yards on 13 plays. Capped by the Kindler rushing touchdown.
Thank you again for your sponsorship to the Olathe West community.
13 plays, 80 yards, Kevin, 4 minutes off the clock. You know, very, very efficient. A couple passes outside to buoy the tight end against off coverage. Real simple pitch and catch at 6-7 yards.
It's T.J. O'Neill, fifth-year head coach, now 40 years old. Doesn't look it. Young-looking coach for the Owls. And he started, I believe, his high school coaching career at Gardner Edgerton as an assistant for his former head coach at Salina Central, Marvin Diener. Owen Dye to kick off. Wind at his back. It'll get into the end zone for a touchback. Wind out of the south. 10 miles an hour. That's Cam Drury as we check in with our sideline reporter tonight. That's Leon Liebel.
You know, you're talking about T.J. O'Neill. He's come from a great pedigree. Played at Salina Central under Marvin Diener, where his dad, Rick O'Neill, was also an assistant. His dad is also an assistant for Olathe West. He's the running backs coach. Good to have your dad on the sideline with you. Back to you, Kevin.
Yeah, 46 years a teacher, mostly at Salina Central, Rick O'Neill. And he is the running backs coach, as Leon mentioned. Grandpa for Annie and Rhett. Two kids that TJ and his wife Emily have. So family a little closer together here. This running play is blown up. Nice defensive work by Spencer Easley, the defensive end for the Blazers.
This is a really good play by Spencer Easley. Staying disciplined. On this read here, you're going to see Mason McGavin pull this, and Easley's right there. Looked like he might not have been down. I think that right elbow might have touched the turf.
It's a tackle for a loss. Second down and 13 for the Owls. McGavin turns, throws, pass caught. Nice adjustment and the catch by Barnard as he gets to the 26-yard line. And he'll get 9 yards. Mason Barnard, one of the original youth football players that grew up playing youth football right there at Olathe West back in fifth grade, following his brother Caden in his program. Now it's third and manageable, third down and four. Quarterback going to keep it and tackle from behind. Theron Mead, the Will linebacker, was coming from the outside. He's on the outside, and he was able to get in behind the quarterback and make the stop, and it's going to be fourth down.
Well, Olathe West trying to run a little bit of a quarterback follow right here, and I thought Mason McGavin might need to cut that outside just a little bit, but Spencer easily in there, clouding that vision. Gardner Edgerton makes a nice stop on third down.
So fourth down, three. The punter is actually the quarterback, McGavern. He's a good punter. He averaged 45 yards per punt. And nobody back. And this one will be a short punt. So they spot this. Spot it at the 39-yard line.
Good 34 yards.
It's only 34 yards on the punt. No return, and now we see the Flexbone offense coming back out on the field.
UBS Bus Lines is a family-owned and operated school bus contracting services company serving the Olathe Public Schools.
Also coming over, Gardner Edgerton was Coach Brian McCall, who's best buddies with Jesse Owen. Ryan was the offensive coordinator at Olathe North. Now he's the defensive coordinator, following in his father John's footsteps, the longtime D coordinator. As they go to the edge, flag is down as they hit one of their wingbacks. Little toss sweep with Butash. And let's see where he's...
Brought down by number two, Sean Swearingen.
Swearingen made the stop, but the penalty is coming up on Gardner Edgerton.
On Gardner.
You're going to see this right on the edge here in this toss sweep.
A lot of jersey grabbing there.
Yeah, right there. You see that little bit of jersey grab outside the framework of the shoulder pad. He's inside the framework of that shoulder pad right there. That call doesn't happen, but just got it outside and they got called for holding.
First and 21. Oatman, one of the faster guys on the team, gets to the edge, gets to the 35 before he is taken down on the play. So Oatman, track guy, senior, getting about 10 yards per carry, and those are the use of the wingback we've seen on the last couple of plays.
Yeah, the offense, with your wingbacks in this offense, you want some guys with some speed there, and that's really just a speed sweep. You're just trying to beat the pursuit and get the edge and get to the outside.
That's seven on that last run. Second down and 14. Elder to the outside, and the pass is dropped off the hands of Colton Hawkinson as we check in with Leon.
Big atmosphere down here tonight, and for Olathe West, a big night. It is senior night, and there's a lot going on. It's also neon night, as all the students are dressed in very bright colors, actually on both sides of the field. So with that in mind, Kevin, I'd like to be referred to now as Neon Leon, because we're in prime time, baby.
I got you. A lot of road construction going on here at Seaback. All those yellow tops on. And now Elder floating down the field. Is a man wide open. He makes the catch. Hawkinson redeeming himself after the drop. Will take it to the house. Touchdown on third down and 14. 65-yard pass that had a hang time about 4 seconds to get to the receiver, but he was that wide open, Mark.
Well, when we take a look at this replay after the extra point attempt, you're going to see why this offense can be dangerous throwing the football down the field like that. The misdirection boots your quarterback out, and Hawkinson came clear from the opposite side of the field, and what a nice throw by Connor Elder. You talk about the hang time on it, but he threw his wide receiver open to the open space and let him do the rest of the work.
Adrian, 2 for 2 on PATs. Here it is, third down and long.
Watch, they're going to fake the speed sweep to the left, pop their offensive lineman out to protect the quarterback, and then just throw this down the field and let him run to it. Great play design by Gardner Edgerton. A great throw by Connor Elder. And Colton Hawkinson redeeming himself, as you mentioned, Kevin, for the drop on the previous play for the 65-yard touchdown catch.
Yeah. A second down and long pass. It hit him right in the hands. Couldn't reel it in, but he was wide open. Remember last year when Elder tore his ACL, Hawkinson played quarterback. Did a pretty good job of filling in for the injured Elder. Now he's been moved to wide receiver, and he's a big kid, 6'5", buck 90, also a basketball player. His second receiving touchdown of the year. Passing game in the flex bone looking very good as Owen Dye, the junior kicker, ready to send it back to Olathe West. This will be in the field of play, and it will be returned from the 10-yard line. Cam Drury, Cam spinning his way, 25 yards in the return to the 35. Olathe West's offense coming out. They're a spread offense. T.J. O'Neill calls the plays as we have a flag down near the 30-yard line.
Block in the back, Olathe West.
So that nullifies a very good kick return by Drury. Owls playing the Lawrence teams the first 2 weeks at Lawrence Free State, winning 33-6, but then losing in a tight game where they gave up two really big plays. Didn't really play that bad and lost 28-21 last week. So trying to bounce back at home tonight at CBAC. And that moves it back to the 19, first and 10. McGavern throwing, pass is caught. And that is Hakeem, the excellent track athlete. Again, they're missing Jack Scott, so everybody's going to have to pull their weight and step up, Mark.
Well, they certainly are. You know, Jack Scott, 10 receptions, 151 yards through the first two games. Was Mason McGavern's go-to wide receiver out with a concussion. The entire receiving core outside of Scott had 9 receptions coming in to this game, so they're certainly going to have an opportunity here tonight.
He got 7 on that last reception. Now they go jet sweep with Hakeem trying to cut it back. Did not get the first down. Nice play there by Easley again, who's having a good ball game, has a brother on the team.
Caleb Green did a nice job from his linebacker position, getting penetration up the field and really turning him back inside to the pursuit of the defense.
Now Green plays the rover position. He's one of their top tacklers. Now trying to convert on third down and short. This is the little brother, McGavern. Now he's a little bit bigger than Gatchett, so I'll give it off. Mason to Micah. First down, Owls.
Nice work. Nice work by Micah here. Really, really looked like he was going to get stuck here, but kept his feet moving. A little bit of a second effort, able to pick up the first down and move the chains for the Owls.
Yeah, Gatchett goes a buck 75, but Micah, the sophomore, is well over 200 pounds, nearly 215. His brother going to run it this time. And actually, Mike is bigger than Mason by about 10 pounds and slightly taller. And a couple of yards gain. Second down and 7 now as you take a look at Mason McGavern. They've got 7 brother combos on Olathe West. A lot of brother combos as well on the Gardner Edgerton squad. Nothing doing in this running play as Gatchett is thrown for a loss. And again, easily in the backfield, having a big game, the defensive end for the Trailblazers on their defensive line.
Well, this play isn't going anywhere with Easley, the penetration into the backfield. certainly making his presence felt here early in this game, Kevin.
Pogue, Carr, Easley. They've got an experienced defensive line. Now a third down and eight. Under a minute to play in your first quarter. McGavran. Flushed. Turning the corner. Battling. Let's see where they spot him out. Looks like he's short of the first down as he tightroped the sidelines. He's being pressured by Green. Green nearly got his ankles here, but he was able to get away from him. But in about 4 or 5 yards, you see 44 there. Couldn't get him down.
That's a great effort by Mason McGavern to pick up positive yardage, because that easily could have been about a 7-8 yard loss.
Mayfield also chasing him around the edge there for Gardner Edgerton, but couldn't get him. And now it's fourth down. And the analytic guys, I would say, would punt here, but looks like they might be going for it here. But remember, McGavern is also the punter, and now we'll get the timeout.
We talked about Spencer Easley wreaking havoc so far here in the first. See the tackles, the guards working together to double team him on the outside. Still almost able to split it. Spencer Easley's made his presence felt, as I said earlier, in this game. Having to give him a little bit of extra attention on that edge.
They're only allowing 19 points per game. They're plus two in turnover ratio. Once again, Brian McCall, one of six new coaches on the Trailblazers staff. Once again, Gardner Edgerton didn't send anybody back to retrieve the last punt, so they're just going to stay at the line of scrimmage and defend this fourth down and three, looks like.
Well, there's a strong, stiff wind out of the south, too, here, Kevin, right? So I think it might be a situation where, like, go ahead and kick it.
Well, now they're going to go for it. Pass down the field, incomplete. As they were looking for Hakeem, the coverage was excellent there. As that was Cam Porter, the honorable mention all-conference cornerback, and he had better position than the wide receiver to catch this ball.
A little double wheel play and a little pressure, I think, forced McGavern to throw this football before he wanted to on the outside. So Hakeem really hadn't got his head turned around yet.
So now, taking over on downs, Gardner Edgerton. Late stages, first quarter, good field position from the 39 on the plus side. Elder stepping back, throwing middle and behind his intended target. As that was sailing incomplete. That was one of these wing backs, Mark, and that was actually Oatman. That pass missed him. So the wing backs are edge, you know, little quick pitch guys, but they also can catch balls too.
Well, this is where you sneak those guys right down the seam right there, like Oatman, because all of a sudden they'll block or look like they're blocking and slip through and get lost in coverage.
Second down and 10. Kindler, who has a rushing touchdown. Get about 5 yards on that carry.
Number 38, Dawson Kindler on the carry. Gained 6 yards.
I'll tell you this, Kevin. In this offense, to play fullback, you have got to be tough. You have got to be tough because you're going to get tackled in every single play because you're either getting the football or they're faking it to you almost on every single play.
That's the end of the first quarter. Sunflower League action on the Hy-Vee High School Game of the Week, Week 3 in Kansas. 14-6, Gardner Edgerton, the visitors, leading after one on the Hy-Vee High School Game of the Week. Ready for the start of the second quarter. It'll be a big down and distance. Third down and 5 for the Trailblazers, trying to take advantage of a fourth down stop. Kindler, good blocking off the right side. It was an avalanche that he followed for the first down run inside the 30.
You talk about that right side, Kevin Jackson Kellogg, Bo Oxley, Ethan Woodley, the center. Just steamrolling the Olathe West defensive line on that right side to pick up the first down.
Kellogg, number 79, goes 355. Big surge, the left guard goes 290. So they've got some big dudes. That's what the scouting report says on the Gardner Edgerton offensive line. First and 10. Kindler gets a seam off the left side. Spinning his way near the 21, a gain of 8 on a first down run. So the offensive line, Mark, doing a great job. As the flex bone has yet to be stopped tonight.
And over the time of this game, I know we just ended the first quarter, but it just keeps wearing on you and wearing on you defensive line-wise with those big boys up front.
But you're right. The fullback, everybody thinks of a fullback is a blocking back, but the fullback in this offense better be capable of running about 30 times a night. And Kindler is doing the yeoman's work as he runs for a first down inside the 15-yard line.
Whole key linebacker-wise is on number 38, that fullback that you talked about. It's unique also because he was only lined up about a yard or two behind the quarterback. That mesh point happens basically at the line of scrimmage.
First and 10. Kindler not doing anything this time as Tank Turner grabs him and whips him to the turf for a loss.
Really nice play by Tank Turner up inside. One way to stop this offense, get penetration. See him beat the initial block.
Also involved was Brandon Rupsoy, one of the safety men, is now Elder calling his own number, cutting it back. That's a good run by the quarterback down near the 5-yard line. So he'll get about 10 yards on that run. Now you're looking at third down and short.
Well, this is another little wrinkle. It looks like it's going to be option, but really it becomes quarterback follow, following that wing back in Oatman up inside the hole.
Kindler breaking a tackle, second effort, and did he get in? No, he's down inside the one, where it'll be first and goal for the Trailblazers.
Just off the left-hand side and initially stopped, but keeps those legs churning in the second effort. Just didn't quite get him in.
Cole Vader involved in the stop. Another tag on the team. Say Cole is their most improved defensive player as they go first and goal from inside the one. Kindler again, second of the night, touchdown, Gardner Edgerton. And now 11 on the season for big number 38 in white, Dawson Kindler, the junior. Fourth down stop is huge by the defense as we see Owen Dye to try the PAT. High snap brought down and kick is up and good. 21-6, so you roll the dice, you go for it in your own territory on fourth down, and Gardner Edgerton makes them pay.
Well, they certainly do, and it was a steady diet at number 38, Dawson Kindler. Just pretty basic. We're going to run the football right at you. Take advantage of our offensive line being a little bit bigger physically than your defensive line and imposing their will.
Let's check in with Neon Leon. Is that what he wants to go by tonight?
I appreciate that, Kevin. I got to tell you, watching from ground level, this Gardner Edgerton offense, it's a machine right now. That flex bone, you know, with the misdirection. I know it's hard to see up there, but when you're on ground level, it really is hard to see where the ball is going at times. Craig Gorrell, the defensive coordinator for Olathe West, had a very spirited conversation with his defense after that second touchdown. He said, you got to be, you know, assignment sound, but it was really difficult to follow the ball. And then you got the threat of a passing game to go along with it. Right now, the Trailblazers are rolling.
Well, Dustin Delaney, he is the guru of the flex bone. If you talk to Coach Dreiling at St. Thomas Aquinas, he'll tell you, when I need the guy to coach the flex bone, I get Dustin Delaney, whether it's an all-star game or a regular season game. High short kick, and it's taken at the 18-yard line. And the return there by Cam Drury. And decent field position now for Olathe West, down by two touchdowns, though, Mark.
Down two touchdowns. You know, really stalled the last drive and had to punt the last couple drives. That fourth down conversion, or failed fourth down conversion, you know, really opened the door for Gardner Edgerton here to go up by two scores.
Gavron running short side and takes a hard knock as he gets near his sideline as he's just across the 35, and it'll be a gain of about five.
Nothing fancy from Olathe West, just a little quarterback follow, and nice job by McGavern. A little patient right there at the end. Looked like he was only going to be about a yard or two, but able to get a couple more.
Officially gave him four on the play. Second down and six for the Owls. Gatchett, who has that long touchdown run. Actually, they fake it to Gatchett, and the quarterback keeps it. That's the second time. I'm going to have to get the eyes checked here. Send me the eye doctor here, because I'm getting faked out on these quarterback read options. Two in the first half, but it's a first down run by McGavern. Gavron to throw on first down. And it hits Hakeem in stride. Oh, man, nearly broke it for a touchdown. Saving tackle there by Cam Porter, but it's a big play all the way down near the 32-yard line.
Well, Hakeem really is the last read for McGavern. He's coming across the field on a simple drag route. They ran a little mesh concept. Two crossers going opposite directions. Gavin stayed patient, waited for Hakeem to clear the coverage, and then hit him for the first down.
25 yards, officially spotted at the 33, first and 10. As McGavern keeping it, running for a nice gain. He's a big guy. He's not as big as his little brother, but he has some big body and handle. He averaged 5.7 yards per carry thus far this year, rush for 1,250 yards last year, so he can handle the workload. Second down and short. Break out of the pistol formation. McGavern rolling, throwing against his body, and a diving catch, and it's incomplete. They say Hakeem did not get his hands underneath. Now it's going to be third down and short.
Moving the pocket. McGavern to his left-hand side. Wheel concept, but this time Hakeem breaks it off on a little bit of a comeback, and we're going to see right here. Ball looks like it just squirted through. Very similar to the non-interception by Asante Samuel last night.
Third down and two, and this is Gatchett. Nice patient run there, and able to get the first down. So Gatchett not the biggest guy out there, but they get navigate for a first down. Good response drive by Olathe West.
I was just about ready to say the exact same thing. This is a nice little drive that Olathe West is putting together here in response to that last drive by Gardner Edgerton.
Now it's the McGavern brothers in the backfield. Mason throwing over the middle, and it's incomplete. Again, they were targeting Hakeem. The coverage was very good there. Looked like Blazek, the strong safety, was in the area. He had some help. Second down and 10.
Hakeem almost came up with a great catch because Gavin put this ball in between two defenders, just unable to hang on to it.
You're looking for a go-to guy to fill the shoes of Scott. It looks like Hakeem is the guy that's getting that role tonight. And McGavern breaks a tackle. Oh, man, he took a shot there by Meade, the Will linebacker, and just bounced right off him. His little brother was out in front blocking for him. And he's able to get a rushing first down. Watch the contact here.
Well, this is the 6 foot, 200 pounds right here. But McGavern not worried about contact whatsoever. Well, you mentioned he ran for over 1,200 yards a year ago and came into this game with over 200 yards rushing in two games.
So, 12 yard line. McGavern throwing to the outside, and the receiver got one hand on it, and it sails incomplete. And that was Micah McGavern. He couldn't reel it in, but that pass by his older brother was a little wide that time. Second down and 10. And Micah, another kid that played the youth football. If you've ever watched an Olathe West practice, they have a bunch of little kids, fifth graders, up there practicing in the field right next to them. It's their youth program. And they give it off on an end around, and the official gets taken down there after the run there by Mason Barnard. And now it's going to be third down. They're still going to need about five or six on this critical drive as the ref got the worst of it here on the sidelines.
Yeah, a little jet sweep. He got his ankle tied up underneath. Tried to kind of jump out of the way.
Head on a swivel, they say, near that sideline. And this is McGavern. He tried to bounce into the outside. Micah, this time, little brother, and did not get the first down. Now it's going to be fourth down. And a big decision now for Olathe West.
Micah is limping a little bit as well. Looks like he might be shaken up. This is going to be an interesting decision. Gatchett's coming onto the field. He is their place kicker. But they did miss the extra point the first time around.
They're going to take a timeout, and let's check in with Leon.
The ref there just took quite a hit, as you saw. And he got up. They were asking if he's all right. All he wanted to know was what score the Hungarian judges gave him. He's okay, limping a little, but he'll be good for the rest of the game.
Greg Culotta heading the crew tonight. Your referee in charge. And now they take the timeout. Mark with 5.5 to go before Hy-Vee at the half. Numbers and highlights brought to you by Hy-Vee. And I couldn't tell. It didn't look like the holder came out there, but we did see Gatchett run out there, but he's also their running back. So what are you expecting here?
Well, if I'm in this situation I'm Olathe West, I go for it here. And the reason being, you're down two scores. You've just put a nice drive together here, really, to answer.
Probably their best drive of the night.
Yes, their best drive of the night outside of the opening one that only took four plays right in a 65-yard run. This is an opportunity, I think, for them to obviously get some points back, but to finish off this drive. I like this call right here.
They will go for it. Gatchett in the pistol behind quarterback McGavern.
Here's the other thing, Kevin. Watch for a hard count down here. They can still get a first down.
Fourth down and three. Jet sweep it to Hakeem. He's going to throw it. Pass. And it is caught. And it is a first down. Hakeem got belted on the play, but able to complete the pass. And that was Gatchett, I believe, with the catch as Hakeem is down, and the trainer is going to look at him.
This is one of those plays, Kevin, that you look at it like, you know, hey, did you go to your two-point play, right? Every offensive coordinator has a two-point play, and there's a little wrinkle here at Hakeem. But watch the great job that he does to get this ball out, because there was no way if he was running this that they were going to get it. And a nice catch by Gatchett, which is going to be the first down, but Hakeem paid the price.
Yeah, Hakeem looked like Justin Herbert last night against the Chiefs. He got grabbed around his chest area and driven to the ground. And, yeah, hopefully he's doing better than Herbert. Hakeem's had a good game tonight. They did get the conversion on fourth down and three. It'll be first and goal from the two as Elijah able to walk off under his own power. So they're now 1-for-2 on fourth down plays. And now in business.
That was a big one right there. We just talked about it. I like the call for go for it right there. Now you got four more chances out of here to stick it in the end zone.
They go heavy right side. They've got three blockers there. McGavern using that strong right side and gets into the end zone. Touchdown, Olathe West. Mason McGavern, who gets up a little hot under the collar. Official Cooper Moore saying, get back to your huddle. You don't need to address this. But it's 21-12 with the PAT pending.
Well, we do have a flag, it looks like, in the end zone. This might be after the play.
So maybe that's why McGavern was so irritated. Maybe a late hit. Unsportsmanlike conduct, Gardner Edgerton. Now, can you go for a two-point conversion after a missed PAT earlier?
Well, you were right. They went heavy, put a couple offensive linemen in the backfield. Really knew exactly where they were going to go with this. Using McGavern. And
yeah, it looked like after McGavern scored, he got it given the business there on the ground.
On Gardner, Olathe West have chosen to take the penalty for this.
So now they'll get half the distance, and they'll go for a two-point conversion to try to make it 21-14 and right back in this ball game. So that penalty could be costly if you're Gardner Edgerton. Here we go. Two-point conversion. Heavy set right. Yep, same play. Second effort. And he did not get in. The two-point conversion fails. And it looked like Blazek coming in from the safety kind of scraped in, knifed in at an angle. McGavern protesting the call. But number five, the strong safety, making the stop here for Gardner Edgerton.
Well, this could be big here, too, later on in this game, Kevin, to miss two-point conversion right here. The Olathe West electing to take that penalty on the two-point conversion as opposed to the kickoff.
Yeah, that was the penalty of unsportsmanlike on 54 after that was Dawson Williams, the linebacker, getting talked to right now by Coach Owen. But they were able to make the stop on the two-point conversion. 13 plays, 69 yards. McGavern on the two-yard rushing touchdown. Two-point conversion fails, though.
Wasn't the prettiest of drives at time, but it was a methodical, well-executed drive to answer the score. The only disappointing part for it, if you're Olathe West, is you didn't execute the two-point conversion, but a nice job to answer on that drive right there.
Gatchett, the kickoff. And the ball is muffed. And now you can't panic here. Running it out and doing a pretty good job of improvising there is Braven Powell Brown. Well, I'll tell you what. Things can get kind of scary after you muff a kick back inside your own goal area. But he stayed pretty well with it and able to get what he can, but they're going to start backed up. There you see Connor Elders-Knight and that long touchdown pass of 65 yards to Hawkinson.
Heavy to the right side here.
Kindler off the left side. Now the defense needing a stop if you're Olathe West.
Well, I think if you're Gardner Edgerton here, you stay within the scope of your offense. You've been moving the football well all night. You're getting the ball back to start the second half.
Quarterback keeping it and is thrown down. And that is Cooper Novacek, Will linebacker, leading tackler on the team. And he was not faked out by the quarterback read option on this play.
No, this is that discipline. He's got quarterback to pitch. Play through the quarterback to the pitch man. Was definitely not fooled on that one.
Definitely going to college, but eventually wants to be a Navy SEAL. And he also is big into wrestling. And I'm sure he plays baseball since his dad is a baseball coach. As the ball is dropped by Hawkinson on a critical third down and seven. So it looks like the Owls could get a three and out and get it back with plenty of time here in the second quarter.
Well, Olathe West playing real soft on the corners on the outside. They're giving up every six-yard hitch available, and this one hit Hawkinson in a bad spot for him right now. It's right in the hands because all he had to do was turn up field, and he had the first down.
That's his second drop of the night, by the way. He does have a long touchdown catch, but. And now we're going to get a timeout by Gardner Edgerton as they're facing a fourth down and seven for Coach Owen. Played for Gene Weir, won a state championship. Then went on to Pitt State to play for the Gorillas, and he played a lot as a running back there.
They didn't have enough guys out on the field in that situation to punt here. So Gardner Edgerton had to take the timeout.
The blood pressure going up for Coach Owen. He didn't like what his Mike linebacker did at tackling the quarterback, and now they don't have enough people on special teams. There's a buoy directing some traffic before he punts. Team captain going to Warrensburg. UCM play college baseball. Pitches in high school, also plays third base. Don't know what he's destined to be for UCM as this is a low burner down the field. Fielded at the 42-yard line. And the return man is hit hard as he got near the 48-yard line. That was Swearingen on the return. Good coverage, though. Coverage was good after a six-yard return by Sean Swearingen.
Getting a little chippy here.
That was Dawson Williams again, who's already been warned about his unsportsmanlike conduct, and he almost went across the line there with the extracurriculars on the tackle. And that might get him another talking to by Coach Owen. It's good to be aggressive and excited, but you don't want to overdo it there as the running play goes for short yardage. Gatchett for a couple. Well, you've got plenty of time. And making the stop there was Ozzie Pogue, the defensive end. We've seen Easley play well. Now Pogue making a nice stop, the turning starter, honorable mention all-league player. Gadget. And the big guy, Dexter Carr. And the defense starting to feel it. Carr at 295, able to get off the blocks here and make the stop.
Well, the defensive line of Gardner's doing a nice job of holding their spot at the point of attack. Olathe West isn't getting much movement up front, so there's really nowhere to go for the running backs now for Olathe West. But this is a big third down right here.
McGavran on the roll, throwing, pass broken up, incomplete. And it looked like Barnard was the target there. Or maybe it was his brother. There was several receivers in a very small area and a lot of white jerseys.
There was not a lot of separation right there at all.
So now it's fourth down and seven. They will go for it. Or will they pooch punt it? They converted their last fourth down try. And he will pooch punt it down the field. Trailblazers will let it roll. Oh, a Kaufman corner special there. Inside the 5-yard line as it looked like it went out at the one.
That ball was really close when it first kicked off the turf, looking like it might head into the end zone. Kicked left just enough to go out of bounds, and you mentioned right at the 1-yard line. It looks like it's going straight, and watch this last little kick right here to the left.
The old left turn, 49-yard punt, and now Gardner Edgerton backed up.
This is where you can't get too aggressive if you're Olathe West on defense here. Opportunity possibly for a shot out of this offense.
Whistles as the ball is snapped. Penalty flags down. Penalty on Gardner Edgerton.
When I say that, Kevin, you may not think that you're going to throw the football down deep right here with this offense, but this is the time you can't get bold to sleep if you're late.
Gardner.
I still believe that this is an old school play, the old quick kick, even on third down. You don't have anybody back. You got field turf. You can run a punt down the field. Now you got to worry about a safety on this penalty that moves it back inside the one. Kindler. Not much. Got it. Spotting it between the 1 and the 2-yard line. Clock winding toward 2 minutes to go before Hy-Vee at the half. It's going to be second down, and they still need about 8-9 yards. Kindler kind of stays low, gets it out to the 6-yard line. Now they're looking about a third down and 5. Olathe West has only one timeout. They're looking for a 3 and out. And now we're going to get a timeout, the final timeout by Olathe West.
It's interesting that Olathe West let that time tick off the clock right there in that situation.
If you're going to burn the time out,
you're going to take it on this third down. You need to take it right away. Because now you've got 1:14 left on the clock. Really lost about 30 seconds there, 25 seconds.
Veteran coach Mike Zagunas there in the huddle talking to the defensive line. Yeah, if you're Olathe West, quick 3 and out. got time. But Gardner Edgerton converts. They can burn the rest of the second quarter clock. Now Gardner Edgerton will take a timeout. They were trying to draw them off sides and get the first down via the penalty. The yard marker looks like it's longer than 5 yards. Scoreboard says third down and five, but that's a long five to me. I don't think they would have got it even if they would have drawn the encroachment penalty. It still would have been third down.
Well, they started this drive on the 1 yard line.
Yeah, just trying to
get
the
space. I mean, it really
is.
The ball's at the six, and they got to get to the 11, so it really is five. It's just the distance, the way it looks from up here. I see where you're.
Well, we've already established
you already established that you need to go to the eye doctor.
My nearly 60-year-old eyes don't see that well. So
I was just trying to agree with you and help you out a little bit.
Okay, thanks. Empathy. My whole life evolves around it. Toss it out to one of the wing backs, Butesh. And he's got the first down. So those guys on the edge, they just kind of do a quick toss sweep. This is Butesh, and the junior converts it on third down and five.
Yeah, just a speed sweep. You're almost throwing a spiral out there on the pitch. Able to pick up the first down.
Now let's see if they just want to run out the clock, give it to the big guy, Kindler. He's hit hard on the play.
I think if you're Gardner Edgerton now, you are just content. You got out. You converted a first down deep in your own territory here. You're getting the football back to start the second half because you won the toss and deferred. So
it'll be
about a three-second difference between the play clock and the game clock right now.
Johnson, the stop, the Mike linebacker, the transfer from Bentonville, Arkansas. And also Rupsoy there. Second down and eight. And the Trailblazers again go to Kindler. And that should do it for the second quarter. Sunflower League action, week three in Kansas. It's a prove-it game tonight. Both these teams, and thus far, Gardner Edgerton leading at halftime, 21-12. Next week, we're off to Bishop Miege. As Rockhurst playing Bishop Miege in our next week ball game, Ivy High School Game of the Week. Let's check in with Leon with Jesse Owen.
This flex bone, is that kind of a key to keeping them off balance?
Oh, absolutely. Yeah, we try to establish the run and then open up the play action pass game and also quick pass game. So our guys did a good job coming out of the gate. We've got to settle down a little bit. Things got a little chippy, and I think we kind of lost our cool. So we've just got to be a little more disciplined.
All right, guys. We'll talk to you later. Take care.
All right. Thanks, Leon. Fans getting ready for Hy-Vee at the half. 21-12, your halftime score. Gardner Edgerton leading Olathe West as you're watching the Hy-Vee High School Game of the Week on Senior Night here at CBAC. Players out getting ready for the start of the third quarter, getting in some stretching as Gardner Edgerton leading 21-12 at the break, looking to go to 3-0 as we take a look at the Hy-Vee first half numbers.
Well, the things that stand out to me right now, Kevin, are the 95 passing yards for Gardner Edgerton in this flexbone offense. You're not really expecting to see a 50-50 split between the rushing and passing yards. The third down conversions also have been key in this first half. Gardner Edgerton, 6 out of 7. Olathe West, only 3 out of 7. The one fourth down non-conversion for Olathe West, too. Penalties have really kind of been at a minimum. Time of possession is a toss-up right now. When you look at it, really, Olathe West, their last drive is really where their time of possession actually elevated on things. But fairly even across the board. The one thing for me, Mason McGavitt has not been able to get going, really throwing the football down the field at all. His receivers have not had a ton of separation. And Gardner Edgerton's passing yards, really the 165-yard bomb to Hawkinson, is really tells the story there.
Well, Gardner Edgerton went to the flex bone offense, and it's paying dividends as they get warmed up to start the third quarter. And we see the running that leads to big pass plays for the Trailblazers.
Well, it does, and this is kind of, I just call it a speed sweep. And I know it's called different, but you're pitching it out almost like a rugby toss out there on the outside. And the different variations, everything runs through the fullback within this flex bone style of offense. And then you're going to see the influence of that speed sweep to the outside. And then you boot back the opposite direction and hit your wide receiver coming on the deep post route. It's these big shot plays out of this offense. You're not going to see a ton of throwing the ball. We saw Olathe West playing off. They took Gardner Edgerton took advantage of it, hitting Austin Bowie early on for some simple hitch routes. But you pick and take your shots throughout the course of the game. That's what Gardner Edgerton has done so far here in the first half.
Next week, Rockers-Miege, the Catholic clash next Friday night. As Rockers has won the last two. And the series 2-2, that's next Friday night, the 23rd of September from Bishop Miege High School. That should be a big crowd, big atmosphere ball game there in Roland Park. And the Owls be on defense to start this second half, as it was Gardner Edgerton winning the coin toss, and they deferred their option in the second half. So the West looking for a quick three and out. If you're Gardner Edgerton, if you can put a double digit 80-yard drive together, man, you could really create a little doubt in your opponent's mind, taking some time off the clock. And
well, we'll see too, Kevin, with this 9-point game right now, how big going for that 2-point conversion and not getting it near the end of the first half could play out here.
Gatchett will kick it off. Deep back will be Randy Singleton, number 10 on the return. And Randy is not going to get to the 20, just short of it. So it'll be first and 10 for the Trailblazers flexbone offense. And they got the couple of rushing touchdowns by Kindler and a long pass to Hawkinson. They're three touchdowns. Going overall, double thumbs up for the offense thus far tonight. Kindler is the fullback. Kindler off the right side, tries to cut it back, but not much doing on the play. As guy shutting that down was Aiden McLaughlin. His father is a freshman coach with Olathe West. Second down and eight. Pitch it out. Butash around the edge. Whipped down by Swearingen, but he is just short of the first down, but a flag is down. They got a hold coming up.
Well, another little wrinkle, though, off in this offense we haven't seen yet. Fake the counter, come back to the option, the opposite direction.
Hawkinson's going to get called for the holding penalty, the big wide receiver. Coach Owen doesn't like it, but that's the call. Holding on Gardner Edgerton.
Holding Gardner. Second down.
These kind of penalties can be drive killers. Look for number four, the big wide receiver there on the edge. Well, I don't know. And he went to grab him. The guy fell down. Nice quick pass to the outside. And it's caught by big tight end Bowie. And he's a haul to bring down. Finally, Longhorn, the defensive back, bringing him down. And it's going to be third down. They're still going to need 5 yards, 4 yards on the third down conversion. Officially third and four from the 26-yard line. Oatman going in motion, one of the wing guys, and then goes back to his traditional spot. Right off the left hip of the tackle. First down and more. Kindler as he broke wide open on the right side. First down as he's out to the 38-yard line. A quick 12 yards on third down.
Well, this is an audible that came in from the sideline. You can see them just wash down the edge. Olathe West doesn't stay disciplined on the outside. You saw Swearingen get his nose inside there on the edge, allowing Kindler to get the first down.
Quick pass to the outside. Hawkinson with the catch. Slips a bit as he cuts. And maybe back to the line of scrimmage is where they're spotting it. No gain on the play.
This is a long throw for this little pop screen. Pop pass to the outside, trying to get a block from that wing back. That was Oatman coming out there, but you mentioned Hawkinson slipping a little bit, allowed the pursuit to get there.
Elder to throw again. Bowie's been his favorite target tonight, and Bowie carries a tackler for a first down out to midfield.
Well, Bowie has four catches tonight, and he's lined up in the exact same spot, and they've played coverage the exact same way for those four catches. Every time he's been out there, they've thrown him the football, and they're playing extremely soft coverage and letting him catch it at 5-6 yards, and then he's just a big load to bring down.
Spotted at the 49. Trailblazers by 9. And with the football, Kindler kind of weaving his way. Nice gain on first down. And this, if you're defending the flex bone, as you take a look at Coach Delaney talking to the quarterback there, Dustin. I mean, you know, he's the flex bone guru, but he led Shawnee Mission East to a state championship in 2014. That was big. I mean, that was supposed to be the country club school. They win the golf and the swimming, but they're not gonna get any football championships. Well, he changed that. So he's done a good job. Second down and 5. And Kindler knocked down about 2 yards shy of the first down. Novacek there. Will linebacker.
Well, one of the things that makes this offense hard to defend is not that many people running. You know, Kevin, so you just don't see it all that often. And so you, with your game plan on a week-to-week basis, it takes time, you know, and you really have to focus and concentrate over the course of the week and be disciplined defensively.
10-ler. He's going to be a little bit short, but let's see how the spot works out for the Trailblazers. Looks like he was about a half yard short. Nope. They say first down, Gardner Edgerton. So he spotted it right on the marker at the 39 on the right hash. And Coach Morrill and defense going to stay out there. And this is the flex bone at its best, running the clock, moving down the field. And now, oh, the ball is mishandled by Elder. They do a practice drill before the game with all the quarterbacks flipping it quick back and forth, and Elder able just to bounce on it and take the four-yard loss.
Yeah, let's take a look at this right here, the mesh point. That ball just goes off the hip of Dawson Kindler, and Elder fortunate to fall on that.
Second down and 14. Down the field. Tight end wide open. Bowie. And he'll take it in. Touchdown. 45 yards. And Bowie was behind the coverage. And it's at his fifth catch of the night. Bowie has been the favorite target of Elder, who just threw his second touchdown pass of the night. And for Bowie, it's his second receiving touchdown of the year. And that is a big touchdown for Gardner Edgerton.
Again, staying disciplined defensively in coverage. You get lulled to sleep with this offense on your keys. Austin Bowie has been a blocker when he's been in tight. They slip him out on a corner route, and he's wide open.
And now they are going for a two-point conversion. As the quarterback keeping it, cutting it back, and Elder will get in for the two-point conversion. Connor Elder. That makes it now 29-12 as Elder saw a lot of blue jerseys, Mark, when he rolled out. Oh, this is the touchdown, first of all. Bowie was about 5 yards behind the defender there.
Yeah, they just lined him up in the tight end position, and he just slipped out, and he was wide open. Got behind the defense in the corner route, and it was a simple throw for Connor Elder. And then on the two-point conversion, they're running a naked bootleg right here. This really doesn't fool Olathe West, but Elder able to get his left foot stuck in the turf right there and cut back up inside for the 2 points.
Because initially when he started the rollout, you saw those blue jerseys waiting at the cut him off at the pass. And, 11 plays. He said if you're Gardner Edgerton, you would get a double-digit 80-yard drive to start the third quarter. The doubts would start creeping into the Owl's head, I think. Now it's 29-12, and they get a two-point conversion.
Kicking off for Gardner Edgerton, number 24, Aston Adrian. Back deep to the Owls, number one.
Adrian to kick off. Cam Drury is the deep man. From the 5-yard line on the return. And Drury taking a big hit. As the special teams work being done there by number 45, Saviston, Thomas Saviston, a backup linebacker. And now you're Olathe West, Mark, and I know there's still a lot of clock time, but
talking for the Blazers, number 45, Thomas Saviston.
I don't know. Momentum-wise, would you like a passing night for McGavern, but how do you feel right now if you're Olathe West?
Well, you have to have a sense of urgency right now if you're Olathe West on offense. You got to come down and answer that touchdown with a touchdown of your own right here. Because in theory, it looks like there's a lot of time left on the clock. But Gardner Edgerton's been able to take time off the clock with their possessions. You haven't really got a quick three and out yet. So this is a really important drive right here for Olathe West.
5 yards on the quarterback read option, Mason McGavern.
Gain of 5 yards.
His brother was in the backfield with him. So we've seen Gatchett, and we've seen Micah McGavran. Sense of urgency. Play clock working down. And they just get the ball snapped as McGavran is blown up on the play. And that is the very fired up Dawson Williams. We saw him a little too fired up and get a penalty, but he delivered a shot there as we check in with Leon.
Hey, Kevin, I talked to Olathe West head coach T.J. O'Neill at halftime. He was encouraged by the way his team bounced back after being down early in that first half, but he says, we got to be a lot more physical, especially up front on defense, to stop this Trailblazer offense. Kevin?
Third down and four. Thanks, Leon. Yeah, turned into a very physical game. Big third down. McGavran rolling and throwing. Pass going to be intercepted. As that was ill-advised throw there, intercepted by Cam Porter, the junior cornerback for Gardner Edgerton.
Well, I think fortunately for Olathe West, Kevin, there was a late hit out of bounds potentially.
So there is a penalty.
McGavran.
Okay, the penalty is on Gardner Edgerton.
There's the flag on the play.
Let's let the officials sort this out, but McGavran ran out of real estate, threw the ball back against the grain. Porter got the interception, but the penalty is the big thing here.
He jumped in the air.
First things first, as they sort this out, Mason McGavran had nowhere to go with the football. It was great coverage by the Trailblazer defense. Absolutely velcroed to the wide receivers of Olathe West.
Personal foul, hit out of bounds, Gardner.
Wow. Big penalty on the Trailblazers.
So you're going to see this right here as he's being chased. This is really an ill-advised throw, and I know what Mason McGavran is doing here. He's trying to make a play. But as he was jumping out of bounds, that was the hit. I think it was a little bit of a product, too, of him leaving his feet. We're going to see it a little closer right here.
Can't see the jersey number of the player, but nonetheless, it is a first down. McGavran using the stiff arm, running hard across midfield. As this game has kind of got a little chippy, and I think McGavran's tired of getting hit late. So you see him running with a lot of passion and fire.
McGavran, 6 foot, 205 pounds, is not a light quarterback at all. He gets out here to the outside.
And that was Meade, the linebacker, that got trucked on the play. And here's McGavran, short side, running right into the Gardner Edgerton bench area. And now another flag. And this might be another late hit or something near the sidelines.
Well, you mentioned this game's getting a little bit chippy.
A little.
We'll see as they sort this out.
Greg Culotta is your referee tonight. I think it's going to be a penalty coming up on one of the offensive linemen for Olathe West.
Personal foul, Olathe West.
Look for the left tackle here, Cooper Zwart, 79, blue.
Well, that blindside block has been a point of emphasis over the last couple of years.
This time the penalty is on the Olathe West Owls. And now we'll move it back to second down and 12. As both coaches can try to rein in their guys. As everybody a little on edge in this football game. Officials still sorting the situation out. He did not get the first down on the run. So it'll be second down and 12 from the 42-yard line. Olathe West zone as they trail by 17 points in the third quarter. McGavran rolling, throwing, pass broken up. Good work there by the cornerback. As Camteo, actually he's kind of an inside linebacker, kind of a hybrid player, got his hand right in and knocked it away from Barnard.
But you're getting a good view right here of this, on this replay, of how good the coverage is from Gardner Edgerton. Mason McGavran doesn't have a lot of guys running open in space to throw the football to right now, which is why you're seeing him have to be patient on these rollouts.
They list Camteo as a cat. Inside linebacker, but a hybrid linebacker, a strong safety. Third down and 12 down the field, and McGavran's little brother cannot hold on. Flag is down, and it's going to be a pass interference penalty coming up on Camteo. Well, the pass was too short. Little brother said, I'm going to pull up and go back to the ball. And he ran into the defensive back.
Pass interference, Gardner. That'll be a first down.
I don't know. That one's pretty close for me. The only thing I can think of looking at that is that the defensive back didn't get his head turned around, and that's what the official was looking at.
So the penalty will result in a first down at the 43-yard line on the plus side of the 50.
We're basically back to where we were when Mason McGavran had the run before the personal foul penalty.
And this running play, not doing too much. That was Derek Taylor, their backup running back, the senior, 155 pounds. And that time, Mead making the stop. Number 22.
It was really a textbook tackle by Mead on the outside. You saw him sit right there, cut off the edge, and then go make the tackle.
Play a 34 defense. Mead is the Will linebacker. Whistles on the snap. Flags fly.
False start. Olathe West.
T.J. O'Neill, a quarterback at Salina Central, won a state championship in 1998. He got beat in Manhattan by Coach Rampy and the Blue Valley Tigers. I was up there for that game. It was quite a game. It was an overtime game. Is this running play?
12, Mason McGavran on the carry.
And McGavran. Not seeing that sense of urgency that you were talking about.
Well, there's been a series of events here with penalties and interception and out of bounds, and it's just kind of disrupted their flow there quite a bit, but I'm with you.
I'd need more up-tempo as McGavran trying to cut it back. Camteo latches on and makes the stop. And now it's going to be fourth down. And they're still going to need a pretty good chunk. Fourth down and five from the 38.
But at least right now, this is fourth and manageable for Olathe West. This is a tough run by McGavran. Pick up 3-4 yards.
But if you don't get it on the other side of the coin, is this ball game?
But you're at a spot right now, if you're a Olathe West, you have to go for this. This isn't even a debate, but I'm with you. This is a big fourth down attempt and potential conversion right here for the Owls.
Gavron. Plenty of time. Throwing. Pass is caught. And it is a first down. Cam Drury, the clutch catch inside the 30. And they convert on fourth down.
Again, great coverage by Gardner Edgerton in the secondary. Not a lot of space here. McGavern does a nice job of buying time. And then a big-time catch by Cameron Drury to pick up the first down for the Owls.
Needed five, got eight on the Drury reception. New set of downs for the Owls as they run short side with their quarterback. And not much doing. Limited gain on the first down run by McGavern. As Eli Porter there. You've got Eli and Cam Porter. They are identical twins. They're juniors. Cole Cam is the strongest, one of the strongest players on the team. Cam is a little bit bigger, but a defensive coach said Eli is the better tackler. So do that what you will. Second down and 10. McGavern to step and throw. And there's nobody there. This could be a grounding penalty. I did not see a receiver in the area. It
was
short.
He's outside the pocket, though.
Okay. So he just threw it away. He's outside the tackle box. And Gavron starting to get a little frustrated here. But, yeah, there was nobody there.
Well, this is really a two-man route. One of one-on-one coverage on the outside, nothing there. And then this is just a smart play to throw this football away.
Third down and 10.
Yeah, now we're in a third and long situation here again, Kevin. You know you're in four-down territory here.
Pressure, pass, caught. Nice comeback route and the catch, but it's not enough for the first down as Barnard made the adjustment, made the catch, but now they're facing fourth down and they're probably going to need about 2 or 3 yards.
Then we're going to move the pocket to the right, a wheel and a comeback concept right there. Again, now you're at fourth and three. Again, you're fourth and manageable. That's still a positive play right there for Olathe West. I know you don't pick up the first down, but you give yourself a good opportunity here on fourth.
Gavron. Pass on a crossing pattern. Hakeem with the catch, and it should be a first down. Elijah Hakeem. Across the middle with a good catch, and it is another fourth down conversion for the Owls.
Well, two key catches that were contested on fourth down. Drury on the previous one, Hakeem right there, keeps this drive alive.
Clock under a minute to go in your third quarter. A must points drive for Olathe West, trailing by 17. As McGavern can't get away from Dawson Williams, the Mike linebacker. Let's go back to the fourth down conversion. Hakeem's made some nice catches tonight.
This is a design play. We're going to look right on a quick screen and have Hakeem coming on a little in route to the backside. Let everything kind of clear out. But here we are at the end of the third quarter, Kevin. 6.5 minutes into this drive for Olathe.
Yep, it's going to the fourth quarter, Hy-Vee High School Game of the Week, Sunflower League action on Neon Night here for the Owls, but they trail it 29-12 after three. You're watching Spectrum Sports. Hy-Vee scoring by quarters. As you take a look at Gardner Edgerton, very balanced night, very good night offensively. They've had no turnovers, made a few penalties that I think Coach Owen would like to have back, but overall they played pretty good tonight here on the road as we begin the fourth quarter.
Well, they certainly have. And then on this drive here for Olathe West, Mason McGavern came into this half 4-13 in the first half. He's 3-4 on this drive. It hasn't all been pretty. He's made most of the yardage with his legs in the running game.
And keep in mind, Jack Scott, their number one wide receiver, is out tonight with that concussion from last week. So that's a tough blow to get by if you're in the passing game for Olathe West. Seen Hakeem step up. Barnard's had some nice catches. Now you must get some points here if you're Olathe West. This is their four wide receiver set. Gatchett moving up in the backfield. McGavern gets away from pressure. And he's just going to take off and run. And runs down the sidelines and goes out of bounds just shy of the 10-yard line. He's going to get about 7 yards on this run here that looked like he was sacked there. I don't know. He got out of the grasp.
Almost coughed up the football there as well, but nice job of making something out of nothing really right there. Nobody open at all for Mason McGavern as he rolled to his left. Tried to step up in the pocket initially, but nice job of getting some positive yardage.
And the cramping starting. Slowly but surely, the cramping will probably come to a close either next week. As you take a look at Jack Scott, young man that's out with a concussion from last week on what I'm told was a play that was penalized.
Brutal hit.
Yeah, nasty hit. And we wish him the best in getting back out of concussion protocol. I'm sure he'd love to be out there with his teammates. Team. Next week, Rockhurst, Bishop Miege at Dahl Stadium there on the campus of Bishop Miege High School. And Miege won the first two in the series that started a few years ago, but Rockhurst has come back to win the last two. Coach Donahoe. This team doesn't have a great record, but they played some pretty good ball. They've given some teams some problem. They gave Liberty North all they wanted, Ray Peck. Should be a great game next week, next Friday night, the 23rd.
Miege this year a little more experienced than they were last year. Went through some growing pains early, a real young team a year ago.
Mac Armstrong, the quarterback. Then on the 30th, Mark, you'll be back for this one. Lee Summit North at Ray Peck. That should be a doozy. McGavern throwing. Hakeem makes the adjustment and rips it out of the air for the touchdown for Olathe West. Elijah Hakeem.
Well, just one-on-one coverage for Elijah Hakeem on the outside and a well-thrown ball by Mason McGavern. Just throw it up high enough, your guy can go make a play with the defensive back with his head not turned around. And Gardner Edgerton has answered here.
Gadget, extra point try. First one was no good, but this one right through there. And there's still hope. Hakeem rips it out of the air from 11 yards out. McGavern.
Looked him off and then a nice high throw. Let your wide receiver go up and make a play. Looked right, came back left. And Hakeem has had a nice game tonight, Kevin. We just got done talking about Jack Scott and missing him and his 10 receptions in the first two games. Coming into this, but there's one guy that's been pretty consistent tonight for Olathe West. It's been Elijah Hakeem. The 16 plays, 77 yards, Kevin. The biggest thing here, normally you'd look at this drive and say, hey, we took 7 minutes off the clock, but it's got to be sense of urgency time, and right now Olathe West defense has to get a stop real quick and get the ball back.
Hakeem's first touchdown receiving of the year, fourth touchdown pass for McGavern. And Game on, early fourth quarter, as this is a boot that not going to be returned as Gatchett bombed that one, and now it's on the flexbone offense from the 20-yard line. It's been very effective tonight. This team not afraid to throw. You know, you want to run clock, but their passing game with Bowie and Hawkinson, especially Bowie, that guy right there, number 89 in your picture, has been the deadly weapon tonight for the squad. So from the 20, Kindler in the backfield. Give it to Big Dawson. Dawson to the 25, and then he's wrestled down there. Gain of 5 on first down.
This is where I wish they had NIL money for high school. Okay, and I'll tell you why. Especially this flex bone offense, okay? You're an excavating company, something like that. You get behind these offensive linemen and run. Throw it out there, it'd be fantastic. This offensive line for Gardner Edgerton has just been road graders all night long.
They have done a good job. They've been very steady. Norris, Big Surge, Whitley, Kellogg, and James. Second down and 5. Kindler again goes low. Somersaults across the 30, and he'll have the first down. And this is just what the doctor ordered for see Marcia Novacek, mom of Cooper Novacek, on a senior night. Her husband, Jay, celebrating the senior night for number 44, Cooper Novacek, the leading tackler for Olathe Northwest. As here's Elder. And he kind of slips down and will lose yardage.
There's a lot of confusion right there with Gardner Edgerton. It looked like trying to throw a little quick screen to the outside. And this is a smart play by Elder. Understanding the game situation. You're up 10 here. 10 minutes to go in the game. Instead of throwing that ball out there in a dangerous situation, he just went down. Make it second down.
Lose 4 on the play, second down and 14. But they keep the clock rolling as they try to manage the clock in the fourth quarter. Kindler, tell you what, he is the guy that's been the most effective as we check in with Leon.
Trailblazers are definitely going to keep the ball on the ground to eat the clock, but if they are forced to pass, something to look for. The wind out of the southeast has really whipped up here in the fourth quarter, right into the face of Gardner Edgerton. So something maybe to keep an eye on.
That's a good point, Leon. They're working against that south wind. And it seems like Bowie, wind or no wind, he's been wide open. He tied in as Connor back to throw, and speaking of the devil there, that is the big tight end. Bowie is just killing the Olathe West secondary as he'll have a first down catch as he takes it across midfield.
How about the poise of Connor Elder on this play? You're going to watch this. Oh, this is the replay of Bowie from earlier. He's had a tremendous night. That was the first couple of catches for him. He's been wide open all night long. They have not had an answer, played off coverage on him. They've snuck him out from time to time from his tight end position for this touchdown. And then he's able to slip out right there for the big play.
So over 100 yards, the receiving touchdown. It went 45 yards. Wind, no wind, it doesn't matter. When you're wide open, Elder is finding him. Nice tackle there by Tank Turner, defensive lineman for Olathe West. Only a yard. lot of people didn't know what to think of this Gardner Edgerton team. They said, well, they haven't played anybody. They've had some easy games. But you play who's on the schedule, and Kindler side swiped after a short run. But I asked Coach Owen, I said, you know, last year you started 0-4, but then you won four of your last six. Does that carry over? He said, oh, yeah. Confidence level, these kids believe now. It's different kids out there, but some of these kids return, and he thought that hot streak at the end of the year kind of had some carryover effect here into 2022.
Well, it certainly can, and you carry that success through it. You understand how to win. If you fought through that adversity earlier, you can carry that over.
Third down at six. Quick pitch it out. And cut back by Open. And we got a flag down as he did not get the first down. And an injured player for Olathe West. Holding penalty on Gardner Edgerton. Injured player is Brandon Rupsoy.
Or bring your vehicle in for convenient
Gardner
service and repair.
10 yards.
And that's the holding call right there, too, as well. Pulling him down.
That was the tight end, Bowie. We were singing his praises as his big receiving night, but I believe that is the holding penalty as Rupsoy is helped off by the trainer and his teammate. Third down and 18 after the holding penalty.
This might be the break that Olathe West needed. Here, third and long. You need a good stop here and then see what Gardner Edgerton's going to do. Do they try to punt the football away or go ahead and stay with their offense on fourth down? But a big third and 18 right here. And just under seven to play.
No, that's the gold when you defend the flex bone. Get them behind the chains. Force them to throw when they don't actually want to throw.
Bowie's lined up right down here at the bottom of the screen in the tight end position. Keep an eye out for him.
Quick pass to the outside. Blocker there. They're not going to get the first down as the catch was made there by Braven Powell Brown. And Braven was looking for a block and didn't really spring him. So now fourth down, and they still need 4 yards. And let's check in with Leon before the fourth down play.
Hey, that last injury on that holding call, it turned out he just suffered a cramp like we've seen throughout this early football season. So everything's okay.
Yeah, Rupsoy back out there on special teams on fourth down and 14. As here's the punt. And this is Bowie with a, golf term, like a worm burner down the field there, rolling inside the 10. It was effective. But if you're Olathe West, the door is still cracked open. Ball game not over.
Now you really have to have a sense of urgency right here, though. It's got to be, I mean, they run from a no-huddle, you know, point of view a lot, but it's just the normal time of an offense running. Now you got to get into your two-minute mode right here. Down 10.
Now the offense coming out. Gatchett, it'll be in the backfield. Gavrin. has four receivers, including his younger brother, Micah, out there. Micah lined up in the top slot. And throws to his brother. A pass going to be intercepted. Yes, intercepted by the cornerback coming up and making the play is Randy Singleton. And he had to scoop it off the turf, and he's able to get his hands underneath it here. The referees are meeting there at the 16-yard line to make sure the call is correct. And it looks like it is a first down, Gardner Edgerton. And that may do it for the Trailblazers. Let's take another look. As this pass was wide from McGavran to McGavran, and Singleton, right place, right time.
Just throws this a little bit wide.
Oh, yeah. Oh, that was well above the ground. Okay.
And that's Mason McGavran's first interception of the season.
Yeah, he is not a big throw of interceptions. Didn't have that many last year, but that's a big one. And now Kindler. His ground game. He'll get about 5 yards on that first down run. And that's our first turnover of the ball game. Pretty well played. There's been some penalties, but take a look at Randy Singleton on the sidelines. Randy is a junior cornerback. Big play. And could seal a road win for Gardner Edgerton. Kindler to the edge. Kindler pounding. And he's out of bounds. I'm going to spot him. Let's see. Looks like he is spotted at the 2 yard line.
When we talked about everything runs through the fullback, right? The Kindler, you got to be tough to play this position because you're getting tackled even if you're not getting the football based on the fake. That's his 30th carry tonight.
Well, yeah, you got to be able to take 30 touches and be strong enough to do that. It's not easy. Yes, here's Kindler, and he's easily into the end zone for his third touchdown of the night, his 12th of the season. And that's going to wrap it up for Gardner Edgerton on the road. And a big win for the Trailblazers. There's the extra point try coming up by Adrian Elder to hold. And the Trailblazers are on the radar. People in the Sunflower League.
Well, you've had 30 carries. Why not reward him with number 31 for his third touchdown of the night, Kevin? Dawson Kindler's had a heck of a night running the football for Gardner Edgerton. And a big portion of that has been what his offensive line has been able to do as well.
Yeah, those guys have done a great job. Bowie's had a big ball game. The Trailblazers tied in, and Kindler running the ball.
Gardner Edgerton's done it through the air as well tonight.
Yeah, no question. I mean, Bowie has just gashed this team. I mean, Hawkinson got him early, but Bowie's been the guy that's been the thorn in their side as far as Olathe West goes. But the bread and butter guy, the grinder, has been Dawson Kindler. And I tell you what, Elder's played a heck of a game. I mean, he's really managed the ball game very well. And this team is, I'm going to tell you what, that drive back to Gardner is going to be a happy bus ride for those guys in white. As they squib it, and the ball will be taken at the 35 and then just right dropping to a knee as the return man. As we get the offense back out on the field. Olathe West missing Jack Scott. You see him there with the jersey number 16, their star wide receiver, not playing, and I felt like that would be a tough situation for the young man, the senior. In concussion protocol after a big hit in the Lawrence game. And now McGavern. Running to the short side. Going out of bounds to stop the clock. Gardner Edgerton, no room to rest or, you know, take it easy as we had a flag down. They got Mill Valley next week.
Wow.
So the 5A defending state champs into the Trailblazer Stadium next Friday night. But you know they're going to have their confidence running on high after a win tonight. As soon as I went into Coach Owen's office, I said, Coach, I know you're 2-0, but this schedule, hey, I know. We haven't played anybody yet, but if we win on the road at Olathe West, we'll have a that'll be a good W as they wave off the flag. And Coach Owen can smile a little bit. Second down and five after the McGavern run. Swing pass, Gatchett, the catch. And he darts out of bounds, about a yard shy of the first down.
Well, Gardner Edgerton's defense has done it tonight, too. We talked a lot about their offense, but defensively, their coverage has been impeccable in the back end, not allowing the Olathe West wide receivers really any space.
Gatchett, first down near midfield. Gatchett had that long touchdown run early on in the ball game for 67 yards back in the first quarter. Gavern been running the ball mostly tonight. His brother's gotten some touches, Micah. Gavern avoiding pressure and taking off. Showing some good vision there as he runs for the first down to the 35-yard line. He'll go for 14 yards on a play that looked like a for sure sack for the Trailblazers.
Yeah, again, nowhere to go with the ball, and this is Mr. McGavern doing everything he can do right here. Now picks up a couple blocks, but keeping the energy going for the Owls.
Speaking of sacks, Meade with the sack. Also involved in the play was Caleb Green, who's had a nice game on the edge, number 44, as they'll get a half each for Meade and Green on the sack, as we'll get a timeout, it looks like.
This is a timeout right here for Olathe West. This,
yeah, the
allow your quarterback to get a breather here.
Yeah, he's gassed, well. Yeah. He's hunched over there.
Took a big hit on the sack. Your timeouts are precious right now, but more importantly, you got to stop the clock as well. So I like this timeout right here. Get yourself back, composed, and ready to take a shot.
Olathe West has a rivalry game next on their schedule at Olathe Northwest. So that's a big ball game as far as the Battle of Olathe. That pass that McGavern threw, that was the very first turnover of the whole season by the Owls. His first interception, but, I mean, they haven't fumbled. They haven't lost any turnovers. They were plus two. Now they're plus one in turnover ratio for the year. As McGavern stepping and throwing down the field too long, that was Marco Johnson, the intended target.
Well, and that's what you have to do. Take a shot down the field right here.
Marco headed to Pittsburgh State to study civil engineering. Showing the urgency. Big, tall, wide receiver.
Run, go,
Deverin avoiding the pressure. Wow, just weaving through the traffic cones and maybe get back to the original line of scrimmage after the big sack. That was a third down and a country mile. Now facing fourth down, still going to need about 11 yards. Gavin, team captain. And guy's showing a lot of guts tonight. He's played hard. He wants to play college football someday. Pass over the middle, and it's caught by Johnson, but not enough for the first down as Singleton, who just had the interception. Great open field stop. And Johnson is slow to get up. Ball goes over on downs to Gardner Edgerton after the defensive stop by Randy Singleton, who had the interception on the prior drive.
Well, Olathe West, a lot of traffic inside. That went Johnson to get open. But it looks like he's got a cramp like his right calf.
So the Gardner Edgerton Trailblazers. Team that last year went 4-6, going to go to 3-0.
First and 10, Gardner Edgerton, ball to 31.
3-0 in the conference with Mill Valley next up, as Kindler still running hard on his 30-second carry there.
He's going to deserve an ice bath after this one, Kevin.
Well, he'll sleep well, that's for sure. Yes. It's going to be a great ride home, as you mentioned. But, well, the secret's out. People didn't know what to think of Gardner Edgerton. They knew they had a new offense, new offensive coordinator, the Flexbone. Really hadn't played anybody early on, and now they've played a good team, and they've come on the road and got that win, as Kindler running for a good gain, as Kindler's been the star on the ground for the Blazers.
Well, he has. It started early for him with his first touchdown run. Shot at his second touchdown, but you're seeing it. 33 rushes, 138 yards, and three touchdowns for Kindler tonight. And I mentioned numerous times tonight, everything within this offense runs through the fullback first. And if you can stop the fullback, then you've got a chance in this offense to force them to do other things, and they have not been able to stop Kindler tonight.
Nope. He has been the hammer running the football, and he runs for a first down. Get some new faces in on the defensive side to get a chance to get some varsity action, but no winding the clock. Victory formation set up by now the Trailblazers. Team that went 0-4, but now they have won 7 of their last 9 games dating back to last year. That guy tore his ACL in week 1, had to rehab in the offseason, still wearing the knee brace. And he has come back, and this team has come back. And it's a celebration for the Trailblazer fans and the visiting bleachers. That's going to wrap it up. Gardner Edgerton, 3-0 on the year under Coach Owen, as they get a big road to victory. They're now 3-0 in conference play, and Olathe West has now dropped 2 straight. They dropped to 1-2 on the year on their football senior night. This will be a disappointing loss for the Owls.
Well, a disappointing loss for them for sure. But they had opportunity in the second half, Kevin, to, you know, to get back in this game. And they put a nice drive together, a seven-minute drive. But unfortunately, it was a seven-minute drive because that was the opportunity right there to score within a couple of minutes and try to get a stop and get yourself back in the game. But a long night, a little bit offensively for Olathe. West, Gardner Edgerton, you got to give a lot of credit to their defense. I know we talked about their offense a lot tonight, but their defense was fantastic, especially in coverage against the Owls receivers.
Let's check in with Leon with the winning coach, Jesse Owen.
Yeah, we got Jesse Owen, the head coach of Gardner Edgerton, the winning coach. And after two relatively easy wins to start the season, you said you thought this was going to be a test. What did you find out about your team tonight?
Well, we handled adversity. We handled hard. Olathe West is a good football team. We've got a lot of respect for them, but total team effort. Just very proud of the boys, very proud of the coaching staff, our community. It's a good win.
How nice is it to have number 89 catching the football? I know Austin Bowie's a tight end, but he looked like a young Mark Boerichter out there.
He's a heck of an athlete. He's going to play college baseball at Central Missouri State. He's one of our captains. He's a stud.
Talk about tests. You're 3-0 now. A little confidence heading to, against Mill Valley next week?
We're going to enjoy this before we start thinking too far ahead. That'll be a tremendous challenge, but we're just going to enjoy tonight.
Coach Owen, thank you so much. Congratulations.
Thank you, Leon. Appreciate it. Thanks.
Jesse Owen, the head coach. Edgerton, Kevin, Mark, back to you.
Well, some high V post-game thoughts, Mark. This is a good win for the Trailblazers. And we will wrap it up after a commercial break on the high V High School Game of the Week.